Hello, I'm Damian Mitchell. Yohan Chin, the Jamaican businessman kidnapped by gangsters in Trinidad and Tobago on April 14, has been set free after 51 days in captivity. Chin is believed to have been released on Tuesday morning, but it is not clear how much, if any, of the $6 million ransom was paid. Justice Minister Delroy Chuck has announced that obeah could soon be made legal, but church leaders have warned that there would be pushback against the move they argued was leading the nation away from God. There is discontent over news that the coffin of former Prime Minister Edward Seaga will remain closed as the body lies in state across the island. Culture Minister Olivia Grange says the request to keep the coffin closed was made by the family. From the region, the Barbados government has announced plans to sell its major shares in the cash-strapped regional airline Layat, but it insists that it was committed to regional transportation and would continue to hold minimum shares in the Antigua-based carrier. In sports, Reggae Girlz head coach Hue Menzies has confirmed that University of Washington Huskies striker Mireya Grey has been selected to replace injured forward Kaylin McCoy in Jamaica's FIFA Women's World Cup roster. In your currency trading today, $1 was being sold for $131.95, the British pound sterling for $169.62, and the Canadian dollar for $99.15. In your weather forecast, on Thursday morning, there will be partly cloudy skies over eastern parishes and mainly sunny conditions elsewhere. In the afternoon, expect isolated showers and thunderstorms mainly across northern and hilly inland areas. And that's it for the Gleaner Minute. I'm Damian Mitchell.